titaniums, the golly titaniums.
I like golly streamers.
They don't have quite the sustain of the goldens. These are nice. They have a little bit purer sound, I guess. They don't have the melodic content, but they are the harmonic. You know, if you play the harmonics, they just really pop out.
Those are really good.
I don't have dead notes. I don't.
This is the double back one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You'd have a little bit more shimmer, a little bit more chorusing with chords. You know, vibrato, kind of natural vibrato or tremulo. Vibrato.
Yeah.
But, you know, depends on what you want to. Some people might not like that. I had one guy that actually complained.
It feels kind of small in my hand, so I don't know. You know, plays very easy.
Yeah, there was a guy down at Arizona State that was ordering a guitar, and he played another guitar of mine that was down there, and he thought he wanted a 640.
Mm-hmm.
And after playing that, he says, "Well, you know, a 650 is really pretty easy to play." You know, I said, "Well, that wasn't 650, it was 655.
655 your standard length?
Yeah.
Yeah. Is there a reason for that? You just like it better?
Just a touch more, I think, tension on it, a little bit more separation of the harmonics, and Bob Rock liked it, and I thought that was good enough for me.
Yeah.
You know?
This doesn't sound like other double tops that I've tried, you know? Definitely kind of has a more like almost a traditional mm-hmm. sound, to use that mm-hmm. sort of term.
Yeah. I think I'm probably closer to it on the solid max. And one of my customers said that he had played it on, and he thought that mine was reminded him of it.
What's that?
I said one of my customers had played Franco Platano's Don, and when he got his guitar from me, he said it that reminded him of that Dom. He said he played the Dom, and he said, "Well, this is a whole new animal, you know." And then he got mine, and he says, "Now I have the whole new animal." So
yeah.
His comments were that he's gonna have to really explore his playing more.
Sure, you know, because you know, there's a lot of dynamic range in tempo. It feels like it'd be fun to play it in a hall.
Yeah,
see what that was like.
Right. You know.
Awesome.
And there isn't really an ideal place here, though, really. I mean, this is, yeah, I guess you know, it's kind of wet here, but
yeah.
And now, of course, there's really no place to really open up.
I actually kind of like the dryness of it, you mm-hmm. know, how you're
right.
talking about that.
Right. Because, right.
Like, especially if you're playing 19th century music,
right?
You got exactly. all those sympathetic
right.
vibrations going on, drives me nuts.
Right.
Right.
Exactly. Right. I think that's where that comes in. I think the song Savage Panic is more for that. So it's in my arsenal. You know, I guess I have two models. I have the Savage Panic and the Solid Pack.
Yeah.
Although I haven't done a sandwich pack with the triangular bracing, so I don't know what that would be like.
Yeah.
I,
yeah.